있으니까.
感觉你很激动，只能为了你的痛。
像这样的生活长着可以值得，像这样坚定你的幸福方法，可以看见那个没有伤害好的你们就放在你的头上，像这样的生活。
是 Friends Academy 九年级的学生，
大家好，我是主持人 Jerry， 是 Friends Academy 十年级的学生。
大家好，我是主持人 Peter， 我和 Jerry 一样十年级。
你们好，我是主持人 Ariel， 我和咱们俩一样也是十年级。
大家好，我是主持人 Ross， 我在 Friends Academy 上十一年级。
大家好，我是主持人 Eric， 我在 Friends Academy 上十一年级。
大家好，我是主持人 Cecilia， 我是 Friends Academy 九年级的学生。欢迎大家来到第二届女人汉风大赏，本次活动由优思美城全程赞助，优思美城留学移民好帮手。
Hello everyone and welcome to the Chinese Traditional Culture Event 2024. This event is sponsored by U Success Education.让我想想，
给你一个小小的hint，这个节日有很多灯笼。
灯笼？哦，不知道了，你说的是 Little Festival 元宵节啊？
这你都知道，太厉害了！元宵节的时候，大街小巷都挂满灯笼，人们还会放天灯，把自己美好的愿望带到天上去。
天灯？你们都来这通话呀？真是来这老好有事。
现在就让我们把这万五千言化作的一声寒暄，有请十一年级的 Emma Wu Mini Yu 和十年级的 Daphne Lee 为我们带来舞蹈《千灯院》。
Let's welcome Emma Wu Mini Yu and Daphne Lee from Friends Academy to present the dance Thousand Lantern Wishes.
在中文里，如果两个男生关系很好，他们会管对方叫兄弟。那两个关系很好的女生该叫什么呢？
让我说说，兄弟 ，you and younger brother。那女生是不是叫姐妹 ？older sister and younger sister。
答对了，在中国古代，春天一到，好朋友们都会三三两两结伴出游，去踏青、采花，心灵手巧的会把花带回来，酿酒、插花。可有意思了。
是的，听上去很好玩，很希望我们一起去 field trip。
下面就让我们欢迎我们的音乐老师 Miss Lin， 随着她的小提琴声，一起去腰东邻女伴，结果缓缓归。
Let's welcome our music teacher Miss Lin. She's going to play the song Tang Li Jian Shi with a guzheng, the violin.
没错，有一句诗叫做江南无所有，聊赠一枝春。
Nothing in Jasmine. I could just offer you a branch of spring.
再不能一起去，但是我们可以先跟随 Mavis 的舞姿去感受一下烟雨朦胧的江南。
Please enjoy the dance, Red Horse for Mavis.
我在江南。
Let's enjoy the ancient Chinese poem reciting from Friends Academy students Juliana Chu, Sydney Wang, Samuel Wan, Eric Jiang, Olivia Peng, Christina Yin, and Ryan Chang.
连
连
夜和甜甜，于是连夜间，于是连夜心，于是连夜难，于是连夜东北。
良人发远征，
昨夜雨疏风骤，浓睡不消残酒，试问卷帘人，却道海棠依旧。知否知否，应是绿肥红瘦。
常记溪亭日暮，沉醉不知归路。兴尽晚回舟，误入藕花深处。争渡争渡， 滩鸥鹭。
醉里挑灯看剑，梦回吹角连营，八百里分辉。夏至午时寻番塞外声，沙场秋点灵。马作的卢飞快，弓如霹雳玄精。了却尊王天下事，赢得生前身后名。可怜白发生。中国有个成语叫文武双全，你听过吗？
文武双全 means this person needs not to be just a scholar, but also a martial art expert. Wow, 太难了，真的太难了。
下面咱们一起看厉害的舞剑。
Wow, let's enjoy the sword dance by Chong Chong and Xiao Wei.
We want to learn Chinese Kung Fu.
Come on, guys. We're students from a Quaker school. Let's do things Quaker.
说到这个 Eric, 你还记不记得咱们春节在学校玩的那个游戏？
游戏？ I heard 游戏。Are you playing a game?
I'm in. 我要参加。
你说那个游戏啊？那可不简单哦。
不简单？我很聪明。我什么都会。Just tell us about it.
这个游戏叫投壶 Pitch Party。
投壶是中国传统游戏，我们可以说它是一个简易版的射箭游戏，因为咱们在室内搭弓射箭不但不方便还很危险。
投壶 Pitch Party is a traditional Chinese game. We can say it is a simplified version of archery because setting up a bow and arrow indoors is not only inconvenient but probably also very dangerous.
于是我们把这件箭把变成这个壶，站在远处把射箭把变成箭扔到这个小壶里。
I guess so. Cecilia and Eric, could you two explain to us how we're going to do this?
Sure.
But your body can't cross this line.
我们的身体不能超过这条线。
Ross and I could be scorekeepers.
How? We got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10,
right? I think that's good. Do we have 10 people?
Come over here. Just come on this side, please.
10. Okay, I think we have 10. So we'll split you guys into half and then we'll start playing the game.So who wants to, Ariel and Cecilia's team will be over here, and then Jerry and Lucy's team will be over here. We need some people to join the other team.
重要啊，这么几个人，就那几个人，买完了，
Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, we need, is your player? Okay.
Alright,
so, do we, let's play rock, paper, scissors between the team captains, and then we'll decide who goes first. So each of you has one representative. Alright, ready?
Rock, paper, scissors, yeah, shoot.
Alright, Jerry's team goes first.
That would be zero, but I don't
know. So the score is currently 0-0. The next team, you guys will switch sides, you guys can go on the other side, and then they will come to this side. All right, so who wants to begin on this team? Anyone? Okay, you got this.
Yeah, I got it.
Ooh, that's unlucky. Everyone's very close, but unfortunately no one has gotten it yet. Nice try. All right, the last one, and then we'll switch sides again. Ooh, very close. All right, we're gonna switch sides again, and now we're gonna play until whichever team gets the first point wins, okay?
First point, alright.
We're gonna switch back around.
You guys are making me and Veer's job very easy.
Yes.
中国的音乐很有创意嘛，但是中国音乐会不会更适合古筝、唢呐这些双重乐器？你好厉害，还知道古筝和唢呐？当然不会了，我们说音乐是全世界的语言。有西洋乐器演奏，传统乐音乐也是别有番不风味儿的。下面就让我们欢迎 Alina Gu、诗渊烨、Emily Lin 和孙蝶洛一起给我们带来长笛演奏《茉莉花》。
Let's welcome Alina Gu from the seventh grade, 诗渊烨、孙蝶洛 and Emily Lin to play Jasmine Flower.
像这个。
我在背诗。
你又在背诗？那我朋友又在背。
我在背一首讲舞蹈的诗，说的是这个人的舞姿非常优美，像飞起的鸿雁，像游动的蛟龙，像秋风里傲然绽放的菊花，更像春日里挺立的青松。
Wow, that's a lot of metaphors. This poem compares the person's dance style to a wild goose, a swimming long, chrysanthemum during the fall, and pine trees in the spring. Very vivid.
Yeah, in Chinese culture, those mentioned terms have positive and inspiring meanings. 那么你想不想看一看中国的舞蹈是怎么样的呢？
中国的舞蹈 ？Ancient Chinese dance? Sure.
下面请欣赏由欧阳老师带来的舞蹈《一梦惊鸿》。
Please enjoy the dance from Mrs. Ouyang.
是的，我们学了古筝、笛子、二胡，还有琵琶。
那你见过这些乐器吗？
我见过古筝。Most of the guzheng have 21 strings. It is a Chinese traditional instrument. What are you asking? Are we going to showcase the guzheng next?
对了，我们的下一个演出就是古筝，请欣赏古筝表演《惊蛰狂舞》。
Please enjoy the guzheng performance.
汉服是汉民族的传统服饰，它是中国衣冠上国、礼仪之邦、锦绣中华的体现。汉服始于黄帝，备于尧舜，传承至今已有4000多年的历史，成为中国文化不可或缺的一枚璀璨明珠。
China has been known as Huaxue since ancient times. The great Tang Dynasty Confucian scholar Kong Inda commented on Huaxue as follows.China is known for its grand etiquette, hence it is called Xia. It is known for its beauty and of its attire and decorations, hence it is called Hua. Hanfu, the traditional attire of Han Chinese, embodies China as a nation of ceremonial dress and etiquette, and a splendidly adorned land. Hanfu originated with the Huang Emperor and was fully established during the reigns of Yao and Shou.And has been passed down to the present. With a history of over 4,000 years, Hanfu has become an indispensable pearl of Chinese culture.
Hanfu 的主要特点是交领、诱人、束腰，用绳带细节、也肩又带钩等，给人洒脱飘逸的印象。这些特点都明显有别于其他民族的服饰。所谓交领，就是穿起来之后，衣服左右前襟重叠，衣服两边相交成领。所谓诱人，就是上衣前襟右边短，左边长，穿起来之后前襟向右掩。
The main characteristic of Hanfu is its cross collar, right over left lapel, and waistband, which are tied with a sash or sometimes secured with a hook, giving an impression of elegance and grace.These distinct features are different from any other ethnic group. The so-called cross collar means that after putting on the garment, the right and left front flaps of the clothing overlap, forming a collar where the two sides intersect. The so-called right over left lapel means that the right side of the upper garment's front flap is shorter than the left
side. 脚步一起去领略这穿越千年的服装之美。
Please enjoy the Hanfu show presented by the models.
We 首先看到的是来自春秋战国时期和汉代的服饰。它们具有交领、皮带、银扣等特点，招旋端、漆身衣、旋端和身衣作为两种代表性的服装形式工具，得到内涵于美观舒适，得到人们的喜爱。身衣、上衣与下长相连，因背体深邃而得名，其特点是可以将身体包裹起来，使身体深藏不露，雍容典雅。汉代的曲裾和织裾是在春秋战国时期身衣的基础上改造而成。西汉早期以起居和为主，曲裾是在深藏衣的前襟。
the early Western Han extend from the front to the back in layers, creating a spiral shape.
越名叫而任自然的风气，对当时的服装，尤其是文人的衣着带来较大的影响。不拘礼法的竹林七贤喜欢包衣博带的服装，逐渐影响到了权贵的士族阶级，也穿着宽松肥大，甚至行动不便的服装。之后，上自王公名士，下到黎民百姓，皆喜大袖、宽衫。 包衣博带，色彩使用素雅色，尤其是白色，形成了魏晋时期服饰的特色，而摆脱两汉时期紧窄、刻板、凝重的风格。The
Wei Jing period's focus on transcending teaching and following nature greatly influenced fashion, particularly scholars' attire. The seven sages of the Bamboo Grove, known for their disregard for formalities, popularized robes with broad sleeves and wide belts. This relaxed style spread to nobility and commoners alike, leading to a preference for loose, oversized clothing and simple, elegant colors, especially white. This marked a shift from the Han Dynasty's tight, rigid fashion to the distinctive, comfortable style of the Wei Jing era.
Shen等 其中儒学尤为兴盛，上儒短小，领口发展出了圆领、方领、斜领、楔形领等多种形态。唐代男子服饰在吸收吴服样式的基础上推陈出新，一改汉魏时期的宽衣博带的风格。常服服饰主要为幞头、圆领袍、衫和革带。
Tang Dynasty clothing was known for its elegance and luxury. Women's attire was diverse, with different popular styles, including short jackets and long skirts, featuring different necklines like round, square, and heart-shaped. Men's clothing, influenced by foreign styles, moved away from the wide robes of previous dynasties to more streamlined, round-collared robes and leather belts.
The Song Dynasty was known for its refined literature-based culture. Women's clothing evolved from the Tang Dynasty, but it also maintained the traditional upper garments and lower skirt style, with popular items such as shirts, jackets, and gauze skirts. Men's attire included garments, robes, and shirts, continuing ancient traditions.
Ming
Dynasty's men's clothing changed from the tight-fitting and narrow-sleeved styles of the Liao, Qing, and Yuan dynasties, with attire such as trailing robes, straight jackets, and armor covers, favoring a broad and spacious style. Ming Dynasty women's clothing really followed the Song Dynasty style, with the main styles still being shirts, jackets, vests, and skirts. A new development was the Mijia, a sleeveless and collarless front-open upper garment.
问工厂销售，太高并泪难流。锦书松罢莫回首，无语随客途。
昨夜雨疏风中，浓睡不想太久。谁问卷帘人去到海棠依旧？知否？知否？知否？应是绿肥红瘦。
昨夜雨疏风中，浓睡不想太久。谁问卷帘人去到海棠依旧？知否？知否？
Friends Academy 的老师和同学们，我们明年再见。
That's it for our performance today. Once again, thank you to the USuccess Educational Group for sponsoring this event. And thank you to the teachers and students of Friends Academy. Thank you, and see you next year.